Hello friends, in my previous video I have already discussed one example problem on discrete time Fourier transformation in MATLAB. Okay, so in this video I am going to solve another example. This is example 2. The question is, evaluate the DTFT, that is discrete time Fourier transform, of the given coefficients num equal to 2 1 10 equal to 1 minus 0.6. And the question is, plot real and imaginary parts of the Fourier spectrum, also plot the magnitude and phase spectrum. I will not discuss the code. Later I will discuss. First directly go to MATLAB and try to solve this. Okay. So num 2 1 10 1 minus 0.6, plot of real imaginary magnitude phase spectrum. Okay. So let's start. This is another problem. One second, first I will clear this. This is the previous code, how I mentioned. Anyway, I will write the code from the beginning. So step one, omega equal to, tell me, here it is asked, see carefully, to plot the magnitude and phase spectrum, imaginary and real spectrum. So what should I take omega range, 0 to 2 pi or minus 2 pi to 2 pi? I told you, if you want to check periodicity, then you can use minus 2 pi to 2 pi range. If you don't want to check periodicity, you can take 0 to 2 pi range. So as here nothing is mentioned, but real imaginary magnitude and phase spectrum, I want to get one realization that we know from theory concepts that DTFT spectrum is periodic with periodicity 2 pi. But is it periodic? I want to get the feeling. So what I do? I take the range from minus 2 pi to 2 pi. At least I told you minus 2 pi to 2 pi. So just let me take minus 4 pi to 4 pi. If you take minus 2 pi to 2 pi, then also no problem. But to check the periodicity, at least range should be minus 2 pi to 2 pi. Must. Okay. Minus 4 pi to 4 star pi. Now the increment is 1. But as omega is continuous, we should increment with very less value. So 0.01 or 0.02, whatever you take. Like this small value. Now define numerator. Numerator was what? 2, 1. Okay. Now define den. Denominator was what? Tell me, 1 minus 0.6. Right. Let us check again. 2, 1 minus 0.6. 2, 1, 1 minus 0.6. Okay. So 2, 1, 1 minus 0.6. Okay. Correct. Now num den we define h equal to FREQZ. Frequus. Because I told you to get the response, we should use frequus. Frequus. Num comma den comma omega. Okay, done. Now subplot. Okay, subplot, suppose I write 2 comma 2 comma 1, because there are basically four graphs. One is for phase, one is for magnitude, one is for real part, another one is for imaginary part. So we should define one 4 cos 4 matrix for subplot. So I have taken 2 comma 2 comma 1, that is first element. So first element, let us take the magnitude part. So plot, instead of stem, why we are using plot? Because omega x of omega is basically, yes, correct, continuous function. So we should use plot omega comma abs of h. Okay. Is it done? No, I told you, you should normalize omega by pi. Okay, you should divide it by pi and you should normalize it. Now just copy this code to save your time, or if you are lazy like me, then you can copy this. Then 2 comma 1 comma 1 will be 2 comma 2 comma 2, and absolute part will be, suppose now I want angle. Okay, now this done, that means magnitude and phase part we already done. Now copy again and paste it, just change that values, whatever is required. So this will be subplot 2 comma 2 comma 3, and now we want the real spectrum. So real part spectrum, and now copy this. Paste it and subplot 2 comma 2 comma 4, and this will be imaginary, right? So image. Okay, done. Just so that we never get any confusion, just better to give labeling. It will be helpful for your examination also. So just I am giving Y label, you can give the X label also. So Y label, first of all, this is absolute part, let us give Y label. What is this is absolute part, right? So magnitude. Okay, now this is angle, so this will be phase. Then just copy this so that you can save time. Paste here. This is what? DL, right? And this is imaginary part. Okay, now just let's hope that our code should run. Copy the code from the editor window, paste the code in the comment window, just click enter. Undefined function or variable den. Okay. See here, I have defined den. Here I zoom it and show you. No zoom is possible. Okay, so den, den m I have written. It should be den, right? Because here I have defined as den. Okay, so just go to comment window, clear it, copy, and again paste. Let's check if this time error arises. Y label. Okay, one more spelling mistake. Y label should be here. Here Y label. Here also Y label. Here also Y label. Okay. L-A-B-E-L. Y label. Right. Now again copy this code. Clear the comment window. Paste it. Click enter. Yes. See, the waveform has came. This is the magnitude spectrum with respect to different values of frequency. This is the real part of the spectrum. This is the phase part and this is the imaginary part. Okay, so I hope this is clear to you. You can clearly see. Now I will explain the code once again from my note. That is omega equal to minus 4 pi with increment 0.01 to 4 pi, giving a small increment will help for continuous spectrum to plot the continuous graphs. Then define the num. It is already defined here. So the same thing you write num and den, that is numerator and denominator. Then h equal to frequus num comma den comma omega. In my previous video, I already explained frequus is the most important line of the whole code. Then subplot 2, 2, 1, plot omega by pi comma absolute of h to plot the magnitude. Then subplot 2, 2, 2, plot omega by pi to plot the angle, and y level will be phase. Okay, subplot 2, 2, 3, plot omega by pi comma real h to plot the real part. So y level is the real part. Subplot 2, 2, 4 to plot the imaginary part, and y level will be imaginary. Okay, simple code. If you know the logic, you can clearly solve this type of numericals. I will also post the same code in the description of this video. You can copy from there and paste it in your software, MATLAB software, in your laptop. By sitting in the room, you can clearly get the idea what is happening. No need to write the whole code again, but obviously you should practice the code by yourself without copying and pasting. You try to write the whole code by yourself, because in examination you have to write only, my videos will not be there. So understand it, write it. If you have any doubt, I am there to help you. Just post your doubt in the comment section. I will obviously respond. This is all for this video. If you find this video helpful, please like, share and comment. And for more videos related to electronics and communication engineering, please subscribe my channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. Thank you.